Hey YouTube, and welcome to another episode of the Albino Rhino Beer Review. You have the Rhino, you have Guy from Beer Guy Reviews. We have this beer that was passed on to us when we showed up at this brewery today. We went to and visited Trafalgar Brewery today, along with a lot of others, and this was one of the beers that was passed on to us. This is Schwartzy Espresso, which they actually, I do believe this one was a gold medal winner.
And what kind of beer?
Flavored stout, I do believe. I'd have to look it up again, but all the beers they handed to us were their award-winning beers from this year. So this is 5% alcohol. Before anyone says it, yes, I'm wearing a Bud Light hat. I actually told this story to one of the breweries we were in, that I did a big tour like what we did today, where I went into about 8 different breweries on that day, and I wore this hat into every one of them just to get every one of them going, because they all knew who knew me, right? Walked in, get that fucking hat off, and I'd laugh at them each time. And, yeah, that's my stupid story.
Hey.
Anyway, Schwartzy Espresso.
Your distance frame, though.
Boom. Leave camera alone.
Filtered water, malted barley, fresh hops, organic coffee, organic French vanilla beans, lactose, and healthy yeast.
What is unhealthy yeast?
The stuff that comes from your pants.
Your anus.
Now again, I just wanted a Sasha Gray beer. Yeast beer. Ooh. Very nice. Ooh.
That's a very
It actually
nice.
Looks nice.
It's good, man. Holy shit. I don't need that much.
I drank a lot before, so...
It's 5%.
Oh, well.
Swirl it.
Alrighty. Wow. That's blacker than black can be. What are you doing?
We'll see.
He wants the dregs.
That's blacker than black can be. A beautiful off-white head. Well, mocha head even. Little tiny snap crackle pop to that.
Smells like coffee.
Woo.
Whoa. Did not expect that from the Trafalgar.
Espresso. Woo.
Not just coffee, but you're getting that you're getting that burnt coffee that has that, again, that little tiny bit of sourness that all high-end coffees have, that just slight tartness to them.
I'm extremely surprised.
The vanilla comes out too after you've let it sit for a second. It's an undertone right under the coffee. You're getting it right under the burn and right under the coffee.
I'm getting that too. Yeah.
Oh, that smells awesome, actually.
That actually smells really good.
Now, I know that I've been very critical on a lot of Trafalgar beers in my time, but I must say, in the last little while, they've had a good deal of really well-made beers come out. The Mighty Oak, the Irish Red is okay. They've just had a whole bunch of beers come out that are actually very pleasing and very acceptable. And their alcohol is pretty acceptable, too.
Moonshine, so, if you go to the brewery, you gotta try their moonshine selection.
So this smells awesome. Let's try it. Here. Cheers. Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, man. Yum.
What happened? Wow. You're amazing now.
Holy crap. Espresso and chocolate.
You smelt the vanilla. The vanilla is there.
Vanilla, yeah.
It's loaded. The vanilla is there. It's big time there. The espresso is big time there. Very, very dark roast just sitting on the back of the palate. It's really nice, too, because at the end, you're not getting that burnt coffee really sitting on the back of your palate like you usually would get on a big coffee beer, probably because it's so thin and so light with the ABV. But what you're getting is a beautiful, like, vanilla note just sitting on the back of your tongue and emanating back up.
Yeah, it's like a toasted vanilla. It's like a Starbucks Frappuccino, like a double chocolate chip with a shot of toasted oak or toasted vanilla in it. It's really quite flavorful.
It's almost like that Bose burnt rocks mixed with
the bottle imp.
Yeah, bottle imp mixed together.
Because that vanilla is strong. It's strong. It's everywhere in there. The coffee is strong. It's everywhere in there. But the coffee fades so quickly on the back end, and you're left with just that emanation of roast and of vanilla. And I'm actually in love with this beer.
You keep your mouth closed, except with the exhale with your nose, it's even better. It's crazy.
Wow, this is really quite good.
You can taste it with your nose. It's crazy.
Yeah, it kind of emanates through your nasal passage.
I never thought I'd say this, but at 5% alcohol with the flavor this has, I think I have to give it like a 9.75 out of 10. I could drink this forever.
Yeah, I was thinking...
I would definitely buy a 12-pack of this and enjoy them. Holy fuck. I'm going to give that 4.5. That is amazing.
I agree. So I'll copy your score. 9.75.
Sorry, I'm saying 4.5 on my scale. It's 9, definitely 9.
So 9 and 2 9.75s. That's an amazing beer. We got a stout strut, bitches. Trafalgar is getting a stout strut from
whoever made this recipe. You're now in charge with the future beers. That was amazing. Yeah.
Please keep doing that.
Go! Bye.